Hello guys, ang tatalakayin natin is Understanding Supernatural. So sit down, relax, and enjoy.
...500 Elite Club members. Only a few will dare join. The harvest is ripe and the laborers are few. Together, we can make a huge difference in this world. Come join this club. You can make a difference.
Okay, Supernatural Lesson 1 is about the Holy Spirit. Kung meron kayong mga Bible, makibukas kayo sa akin sa Mark 3, verse 16 to 17. Sabi dyan, And when he had baptized, Jesus came up immediately from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and aligning upon him, and suddenly a voice came from heaven saying, "This is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased." Sige po, tayo manalangin. Panginoon, maraming po salamat sa pagkakataon na pag-aralan po ang mga salita mo. At patuloy nga po namin in-acknowledge na kayo pong pinakamagaling na guro na meron kami sa lugar pong ito. At dalayan po namin, buksan niyo po ang aming mga puso at pandinig. Ano mong bagay na dapat naming ayusin at baguhin kayo pong patuloy na magtuturo nito sa amin. Ikaw lamang po ang patuloy na maitataas sa aming kalagitnaan, wala na pong iba. Ito po yung aming dalangin sa pangalan po ni Jesus. Amen. So we would like to clarify ahead of time, the Holy Spirit is not the power of God. The Holy Spirit is God Himself. Now this is, ang sinasabi natin dito is person, but then again, ang ibig sabihin din dito is character. So God has three, God is only one individually and He showed Himself in three characteristics. Sa Old Testament, He showed Himself as the Father. Sa New Testament, He showed Himself as the Son. And for a lack of a better term, sa atin ngayon, sa church age, He is showing Himself as the Holy Spirit. Sabi nga natin dito, His personality. So there are certain passages which refer to all three members of the Trinity. In Matthew 28, verse 19, "Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." In 2 Corinthians 13, verse 14, "The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen." So the membership of the Holy Spirit in the Holy Trinity is itself proof of the personality of the Holy Spirit. Additional proof of His personality is found in the fact that the attributes of personality and are manifested by Him. Kung titingnan natin, the Holy Spirit has a mind in Romans 8 verse 27. "Now He who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is because He makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God." In 1 Corinthians 12 verse 11, "But one and the same Spirit works all these things, distributing to each one individually as He wills." In Ephesians 4 verse 30, "He has an emotion. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption." So, this is the characteristic of the Holy Spirit. Kaya hindi siya power lang ni Lord. He's really existing kung titingnan natin. But then again, we would like to clarify, you're not seeing three different gods, you're seeing three characteristics of one individual God. And at this time, ating inaral is the Holy Spirit. So personal activities are also ascribed to the Holy Spirit. Sabi dyan sa Genesis 6 verse 3, "He strives with sinners." In John 14 verse 26, "He teaches." In John 15 verse 26, "He testifies of Christ." In John 16 verse 8, "He reproves." In John 16 verse 13, "He guides." In Acts 9 verse 31, "He comforts." In Romans 8 verse 26, he helps our infirmities and intercedes with us. In 1 Corinthians 2 verse 10, "He searches. In Romans 15, verse 16, he sanctifies. In Romans 8, verse 16, he witnesses. In Acts 16, verse 6, he commands. In Acts 5, verse 3, he cannot be lied to. In Acts 7, verse 51, he cannot be resisted. In Matthew 12, verse 31 to 32, he can be blasphemed. In Ephesians 4, verse 30, he can be grieved. In 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 19, he can be quenched. So there are those who have a difficulty in distinguishing being personality or being a person and corporate or having a body. Having the faculties and attributes of a person constitutes a person whether or not that person customarily resides in a body. So again, that is a characteristic. So the Holy Spirit exists in this, hindi nga lang siya power, kundi He really is existing. Now, yung deity, the deity of the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit is God and is proven not only by His identification with God in the baptismal formula and apostolic benediction, but also in His possession of God-like attributes. In Hebrews 9, verse 14, He is the eternal Spirit. In Psalms 139, verse 7 to 10, He is omnipresent. In Luke 1, verse 37, as we see, He is omnipresent in Psalms 137, verse 7 to 10. In Luke 1:37, He is omnipotent. In 1 Corinthians 2, verse 9, verse 10, He is omniscient. In Genesis 1, verse 2, He shared in creation. In John 3, verse 5, He creates new creatures. In Romans 8, verse 11, He raised Christ from the dead. Now, the names of the Holy Spirit. There are four major names of the Holy Spirit. Una, yung Holy Spirit. Pangalawa, Spirit of God, Spirit of Christ, and Counselor. So, these are not different Holy Spirit. These are the names or another characteristic of the Holy Spirit na kinakabit sa kanya para mas lalo nating maintindihan yung pagkilos ng banal na Espiritu. So, these different terms call attention to certain functions or attributes which this same person manifests on different occasions. Jesus is called Redeemer, Savior, Son of God, Son of Man, Prince of Peace, Word of God, Bridegroom, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Apostle, High Priest, Shepherd, to indicate various functions and relations which he possesses. So it is proper that different names be used in connection with the Holy Spirit. Para nga mas lalo nating maunawaan yung kanyang function, yung paggalaw ng Holy Spirit sa ating mga buhay or paggalaw ng Diyos sa ating mga buhay, especially in this church age. So the Holy Spirit, also known as the Spirit, in 1 John 3 verse 24, now he who keeps his commandments abides in him and he in him. And by this we know that he abides in us by the Spirit whom he has given. In 1 Corinthians 2 verse 10, but God has revealed them to us through the Spirit, through his Spirit, for by the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God. So the name most frequently accorded to the third person of the Trinity is the Holy Spirit. Now, emphasis is on holiness. In Revelation 4, verse 8, the four living creatures, each having wings, six wings, were full of eyes around and within, and they do not rest day or night. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, who was and is and who is to come. So the first thing that must be expected in dealing with the Holy Spirit is that He will answer and condemn sin in our life based on John 16 verse 8. Sabi nga doon, and when He has come, He will convict the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. So again, He will answer and condemn sin in our life. This is His major ministry as the Holy Spirit. Now, the Spirit of God. In Ephesians 4, verse 30, and do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. In 1 John 4, 2, by this you know the Spirit of God, every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is of God. So this name draws attention to the fact that he has a specific relationship to the Father. In John 15 verse 26, but when the Helper comes, whom I shall send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who proceeds from the Father, he will testify of me. So the fact that he proceeds from the Father justifies this name. The Spirit of God, in the capacity of the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit does the work of the Father here on the earth. Now, A, as the Spirit of God, ang sabi natin dito, he draws men to Christ. In John 6 verse 44, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. Letter B, he reveals the truth in Matthew 16, verse 17. Jesus answered and said to him, "Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven." In Matthew 11, verse 25, at that time Jesus answered and said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and prudent and have revealed them to babies. So again, before the day of Pentecost, it was the Father's work to reveal truth to men. Now, ang nangyari, it is the Holy Spirit revealing the truth to us by the Word of God. The Holy Spirit will lead us into all truth, point us to the Word of God, show us the Lord Jesus Christ. Kasi as the Bible emphasized also that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Letter C, he guides. In John 12, verse 49 to 50, "For I have not spoken on my own authority, but the Father who sent me and gave me, and who sent me, gave me a command what I should say and what I should speak. And I know that his command is everlasting. Therefore, whatever I speak, just as the Father has told me, so I speak." Now, the Holy Spirit is come, or has come, kung titignan natin, in Romans 8, verse 14, "For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are sons of God." So tayo, na merong relasyon sa Diyos, tinanggap si Kristo sa ating mga buhay, ang banal na Espiritu ay nananahan na sa atin ngayon. We are sealed by the Holy Spirit. Letter D, he disciplines. In John 15, verse 2, "Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away, and every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit." In Hebrews 12, verse 6, "For whom the Lord loves, he chastens, and scourges every son whom he receives." Now carried out by the Holy Spirit in Isaiah 4, 4, sabi nga, "When the Lord has washed away the filth of the daughters of Zion and purge the blood of Jerusalem from her midst by the spirit of judgment and by the spirit of burning." Now the Spirit of Christ in Romans 8 verse 9, "But you are not in the flesh but in the Spirit, if indeed the Spirit of God dwells in you. Now if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he is not of his." So when this term is used, attention is called to the fact that he was given by Christ himself. In John 16, verse 7, "Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is to your advantage that I go away, for if I do not go away, the helper will not come to you, but if I depart, I will send him to you." In John 20:22, "And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit." So in the capacity of being sent by Christ, he imparts Christ's life. Kaya ang nangyari, we are righteous right now, it's because of the righteousness of Christ in our lives. In Romans 8 verse 2, "For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death." In 1 John 5, verse 11 to 12, "And this is the testimony that God has given us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. He who has the Son has life. He who does not have the Son of God does not have life." Life is in the Son of God, and the Spirit of Christ is called the Spirit of Life. The impartation of the Christ life is the work of the Holy, is the work of the Spirit of Christ, or the work of the Holy Spirit. Kaya ngayon, again, we are considered righteous because of the Holy Spirit living in us, which is God Himself, and Christ also, na kung saan yung righteousness ni Lord ay nasa atin right now as believers. Letter B, He produces Christ's fruits. Kasi yung pagbabago, ang Diyos ang gagawa niyan sa atin. Yung bunga ng banal na Espiritu, yan yung maturity nakikita natin sa mga sarili natin. As we apply the Word of God in our lives, in our daily lives, then nakikita yung maturity sa atin. Sabi natin dito, Philippians 1 verse 11, being filled with the fruits of righteousness which are by Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God. So the Christ life within is the seedbed from which this arises and are produced various kinds of Christian fruits. Sabi doon sa Galatians 5:20-23 uli, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such there is no law. So it is the work of the Holy Spirit as the Spirit of Christ to develop the Christ life within the believer, in the production of the various qualities which are called the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Letter C, He reveals the things of Christ. In John 16 verse 14, He will glorify me, for He will take of what is mine and declare it to you. So our Lord came to set us a perfect example of Christian living for us to follow. Kaya nga, ang goal natin as individual Christians is to be like Christ. So the Holy Spirit will glorify Christ by taking these things of Christ and reveal to us the secret of the success of His life, enabling us to walk in the same pathway and the same glorious victory. Letter D, He imparts the power of Christ. In Matthew 28 verse 18, and Jesus came and spoke to them saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. In 1 Corinthians 1 verse 24, but to those who are called both Jews and Greeks, Christ, the power of God and the wisdom of God. So the outstanding characteristic of the infilling of the Holy Spirit as promised by Christ is that it would be endowed with power from on high. We will be empowered by the Holy Spirit na kung saan malalakaran natin ang kalooban ng Diyos at makikita ang bunga ng Espiritu sa buhay natin. Letter E, He takes the place of Christ. In John 14 verse 16, and I will pray the Father and He will give you another helper that He may abide with you forever. So the Holy Spirit was to be to them a personal friend, a wonderful teacher, a very real companion, and a guide. So the Holy Spirit is the comforter. In John 14 verse 16, sabi nga, and I will pray the Father and He will give you another helper that He may abide with you forever. So in no other place in the scriptures is the Holy Spirit referred to by this title. The hearts of the disciples were troubled. They were in need of divine comfort. Jesus supplies this need by the promise of the gift of Him who brings abundant comfort to their hearts. The comfort which He would bring would not merely be sympathy, but would affect a complete healing of their wounded hearts by the impartation of courage and strength. In Acts 9 verse 31, sabi nga, then the churches throughout all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria had peace and were edified and walking in the fear of the Lord and in the comfort of the Holy Spirit, they were multiplying. Now, paraclete translated as a comforter. It means more than one who comforts. He is one who walks alongside or in companion or is a companion. A paraclete, the Holy Spirit, is one who is ready to provide strength, courage, wisdom, and grace in any form. In 2 Corinthians 13 verse 14, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Okay, communing of the Holy Spirit in 2 Corinthians 13 verse 14. Sabi nga, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. So communing with the Holy Spirit, having fellowship with Him, letting Him perform His appointed ministry in our lives, brings to us the fullness of the blessings of God. Now the seven spirits of God in Ephesians 4 verse 4, there is one body, one spirit, just as you were called in one hope of your calling. This is a declaration of the unity of the Holy Spirit. He is a distinct person with a unique personality of His own. It is true that He is called the Spirit of God, the Spirit of Christ, as well as the Holy Spirit. These are His outstanding titles, but He is one person performing different ministries. So again, kung titignan natin to, makikita natin na ang Holy Spirit nga, pinakita niya uli ang kanyang sarili in seven different ways. Hindi seven different Holy Spirit, kundi seven different ways. Kasi nga sabi natin, for a lack of a better term, noon, ang main player is the God the Father. Sa New Testament is Jesus Christ. Now, in the church age, that's the Holy Spirit. So, in order for us to understand more of God through the Holy Spirit manifested Himself in seven different ways. Sabihin natin dito, in Revelation 1 verse 4, John to the seven churches which are in Asia, grace to you and peace from Him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before His throne. So the unity of the Spirit finds expression in seven distinctive ways. The Supreme God is one in very truth. In Deuteronomy 6 verse 4, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one. And yet the Bible sets forth that there are three distinct persons in the Godhead. Again, these are three characteristics of one individual God. So, huwag kayong malilito ron. Iisa lang ang Diyos natin, minanifest niya yung sarili niya sa tatlo para mas lalo nating maunawaan kung sino ang Diyos sa atin kahit papano. Although hindi natin makikita talaga yung kanyang kaluwalhatian, pero at least kahit papano, we would see a glimpse kung sino ba ang Diyos at ano ba ang nais ng Diyos na ipahayag sa atin. Sabi nga natin, as the candlesticks of the wilderness tabernacle was made of one piece of beaten gold that had seven branches and lamps, based on Exodus 25 verse 31 to 37, so the Holy Spirit is one and yet shines forth upon the world in seven different ways. Una, the Spirit of grace. In Hebrews 10 verse 29, of how much worse punishment do you suppose will be thought worthy who has trampled the Son of God underfoot, counted the blood of the covenant by which He was sanctified a common thing, and insulted the Spirit of grace. In Ephesians 2 verse 8 to 9, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. So the Holy Spirit presents heaven's treasures as gracious gift to men. He refuses to deal with those who would barter with Him. Grace is the fundamental law of His ministry. There is no limit to what He will give and do as we accept it as unmerited favor. So because of the Holy Spirit, we see the grace of God that even though na tayo ay makasalanan, nakikita natin tinatanggap pa rin tayo ng Panginoon. Number 2, the Spirit of life. In Romans 8 verse 2, sabi dyan, for the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus had made me free from the law of sin and death. But if the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, He who raised Christ from the dead will also give you life to your mortal bodies through His Spirit who dwells in you. So He is the Spirit of life, makes us free. He is the Spirit of life, makes us free from the law of sin and death. Dahil sa Kanya, tayo ngayon ay pinalaya sa kasalanan at ngayon ay mayroong kabanalan dahil kay Kristo at sa banal na Espiritu. So the Spirit of Life can and will penetrate our physical bodies and quicken them. There is a divine healing as the gift of the Holy Spirit in 1 Corinthians 12 verse 9. So to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healing by the same Spirit. So there is a divine healing available to us. Sabi dun sa 2 Corinthians 4 verse 10 to 11, always caring about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus Christ, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our body. For we who live are always delivered to death for Jesus' sake, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our mortal flesh. Now there is a supernatural strength available in John 14 verse 6. Sabi nga doon, and the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him, and he tore the lion apart as one who would torn apart a young goat, though he had nothing in his hand, but he did not tell his father or his mother what he has done. So this is talking about Samson. Now there is a divine transportation available in Acts 8 verse 39. Sabi diyan, now when they came up out of the water, the spirit of the Lord caught Philip away so that the eunuch saw him no more, and he went on his way rejoicing. In verse 40, but Philip was found at Azotus, and passing through, he preached in the cities till he came to Caesarea. So para tong beam me up, Scotty, ng Star Trek. You know, kumbaga nasa isang lugar, biglang mapupunta sa ibang lugar. Number 3, the spirit of adoption in Romans 8 verse 15. For you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you received the spirit of adoption by whom we cry out, Abba, Father. So the special work of establishing former sons of Satan into the family of God as his legal heirs is a particular ministry of the Holy Spirit. The word adoption in the Greek is an interesting word, meaning literally the placing of sons. It comes from two words, huios, which is son, and thesis, placing. Our birth into the family of God is rather expressed by another Greek word, technon, a word which John uses to express a relationship based upon community of nature. He never uses the word huios to describe the relation of Christians to God, since he regards their position not as the result of adoption, but of a new life. Paul regards the relationship from a legal standpoint as adoption imparting a new dignity and relationship. So again, hindi lang tayo inadapt ng Panginoon, kundi ang nangyayari dito, the very nature of God, which is the Holy Spirit, is dwelling in us right now. Sabi nga rin sa Galatians 4 verse 5 to 7, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. And because you are sons, God has set forth the Spirit of His Son into your hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. Therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. The whole thought of adoption is that we now stand in the completeness of relation to God as sons, which makes us heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus Christ. He, the only begotten Son, and we, the many sons, whom He is bringing to glory in Hebrews 2 verse 10. It is the ministry of the Holy Spirit to actualize that sonship. In Galatians 4 verse 7, having a therefore you are no longer a slave but a son, and if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. And to inspire us with the utmost confidence in our approach to God. Because we are children of God, as the Holy Spirit would convict us and emphasize that to us. So one day, as Paul indicates in Romans 8 verse 23, having a not only that, but we also who have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves grown within ourselves, eagerly waiting for the adoption, the redemption of our body. So we shall enter into the consummation of adoption by the redemption of our body, or tinatawag natin glorified body. We shall be manifested as sons in Romans 8 verse 19 before the wandering heavenly host, and all creation will rejoice in what God has wrought through us, brought through grace in redeeming a fallen race. Now, the spirit of holiness in Romans 1 verse 4. Sabi nga, and declared to be the Son of God with power according to the spirit of holiness by the resurrection of the dead. So the spirit of holiness as the spirit of judgment uncovers and condemns all that is wrong. And as the spirit of burning purges it out, this is a work which is not so pleasant to the believer, but is very vital to the program of God. So to be filled with the Holy Spirit means to allow the Holy Spirit to search out, condemn, and destroy all the impurities of the nature. In Luke 1:35, and the angel answered and said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the highest will overshadow you. Therefore, also the Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God. So that holy thing, again, the Holy Spirit is emphasizing on holiness. So as the tree is sustained by the life within, so the person within one's life is the secret of true holiness, and the Holy Spirit of holiness is that person. Meaning, kailangan natin ma-recognize ang Holy Spirit at hingin parati ang tulong ng Diyos nang sa gayon lumakad tayo ng mayroong katwiran at kabanalan sa harapan ng Diyos at sa harapan ng tao. Number 5, the spirit of supplication. In Zechariah 12 verse 10, and I will pour on the house of David and on the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and supplication. Then they will look on me whom they pierced. Yes, they will mourn for him as one mourns for his only son, and grieve for him as one grieves for his firstborn. So the Holy Spirit is so efficient and capable by reason of the fact that He is God. Now we will emphasize that the Holy Spirit is not the power of God. The Holy Spirit is God Himself. Again, that He is God Himself and knows all things, that He is preeminently qualified to control and guide the prayer life of the believer. Speaking through the Spirit-filled saints in the gifts of the unknown tongue, or by inspiring the human understanding, He is the mighty spirit of supplications. How much more could be accomplished for God if Spirit-filled people would yield themselves to the mighty ministry of intercession, as the Spirit of supplication Himself prayed through them according to the will of God. Number 6, the Spirit of Truth. In John 16, verse 13, however, when He, the Holy Spirit, has come, He will guide you into all truth, for He will not speak on His own authority, but whatever He hears, He will speak, and He will tell you things to come. So His chief emphasis concerning the work and ministry of that Comforter was that He would teach them all things. Sabi nga sa John 14, verse 26, But the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, He will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all that I have said to you. So He also stated that when the Spirit of Truth was come, He should testify of Jesus, of Him, in John 15, verse 26. Now, since Christ Himself is truth, based on John 14, verse 6, it is to be expected that the Spirit of Truth would testify of Christ, who is the truth. So He would point out to Christ. Christ is always pointing out to the Father, because again, the three are one. So knowledge is light and permits proper adjustment to the facts of life. The spiritual realm is uncharted, and yet it is the sphere through which we must find our way in order to have power over sin, the world, and the devil. How are we to find our way? A guide has been sent to us, and that is through the Holy Spirit. Kaya pansin niyo, pag sinisiraan tayo ng gospel or nagsisira tayo ng gospel sa mga wala pa kay Kristo, nandoon yung conviction of the Holy Spirit for them to see the way, the truth, and the life, which is the Lord Jesus Christ. Sa atin naman na meron ng relasyon sa Diyos, ang ginagamit ng Banal na Espiritu ng Diyos ay ang salita niya para ipakita sa atin yung katwiran at katotohanan. Number 7, the Spirit of Glory. In 1 Peter 4, verse 14, if you are reproached for the name of Christ, blessed are you, for the Spirit of glory and of God rests upon you. On their part, he is blasphemed, but on your part, he is glorified. So this was the Spirit that rested upon Stephen as his enemies gnashed on him with their teeth and prepared to stone him, based on Acts 7, verse 55. Stephen was glorified, for the Lord stood to receive him. Now, the Holy Spirit in the Old Testament. The Holy Spirit is mentioned 81 times in the Old Testament. At creation, in Genesis 1, verse 2, with the antediluvians, or with the unbelievers or sinners, in Genesis 6, verse 3. So here is a revelation of the ministry of the Holy Spirit in the Old Testament, which is similar to that which we have in the New Testament. He now reproves the world of sin and draws men to Christ. Now, in the case of Joseph and Bezalel in Genesis 41:38 and Exodus 31, verse 1 to 6. So there are many instances of special visitations of the Holy Spirit in the Old Testament upon individuals who were equipped to perform certain functions. So very active na ang Holy Spirit kahit noon pa in the Old Testament. As we see through the life of Moses, through the life of Joshua, and through the 70 elders and the judges. In the case of Saul and David, sabi nga dito, when the time came that Israel desired a king, God gave them Saul and equipped him for his work by the Holy Spirit coming upon him. Based on 1 Samuel 10, verse 1 to 6. So look at the four very specific things the anointing accomplished in the life of Saul when he experienced the Holy Spirit. Sabi nga, we can expect these same four things to be accomplished through us as well. Ano yun? Una, supernatural restoration. As we see, yung hinahanap niya mga hayop ay natagpuan. Number 2, supernatural progress. He go on forward. Number 3, supernatural provision. Strangers has provided for him. Number 4, supernatural promotion. So change into another man. He was a king. By that time, nung na-experience niya yung Holy Spirit, he became a king and anointed by the Lord. So the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul after the willful king continually disobeyed in 1 Samuel 16, verse 14. So his successor, David, received the anointing in 1 Samuel 16, verse 13. Now, in the life of the prophets, sabi nga natin dito in 1 Peter 1, verse 11, searching what or what manner in time the Spirit of Christ who was in them was indicating when he testified beforehand the sufferings of Christ and the glories that would follow. So we see that the Holy Spirit came upon certain individuals in the Old Testament. It was predicted that the time would come when he would similarly be poured out into all flesh. Dun sa Joel 2 verse 28 to 29. It was further prophesied that he would rest mightily upon the coming Messiah in Isaiah 11 verse 1 to 3. Now, the Holy Spirit in the time of Jesus. The Holy Spirit at the birth of John and Jesus in Luke 1, verse 15, verse 35, verse 41, and verse 67. So, we have seen distinct references to the Holy Spirit in the first two chapters of Luke with accompanying crying out and prophesying under the power of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' ministry, he was baptized in the Holy Spirit in Matthew 3, verse 16. When he had been baptized, Jesus came up immediately from the water, and behold, the heaven were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and aligning upon him. Driven by the Holy Spirit into the wilderness in Mark 1, verse 12. Immediately, the Spirit drove him into the wilderness, or lead him. He returned in the power of the Holy Spirit in Luke 4, verse 14. Then Jesus returned the power of the Holy Spirit to Galilee, and news of him went out through all the surrounding regions. So he cast out devils by the Spirit, by the Holy Spirit, in Mark 12:28, offered himself to God through the Holy Spirit, in Hebrews 9:14, commanded his disciples through the Spirit, in Acts 1:2. Now John predicts the general outpouring of the Holy Spirit in Luke 3:16. Now, the Holy Spirit in conversion. Ano ba yung ginagawa ng Banal na Espiritu in convicting a person when we share the gospel to that person, or when the Holy Spirit is convicting us of the sins that we are doing or have done? Sabi nga natin dito, in John 16:8, and when he has come, he will convict the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. So at the very beginning of the salvation process, it is the Holy Spirit who takes the initiative and brings conviction to the sinning heart. Again, ang Holy Spirit ang gagawa nun, hindi tayo. Kaya nga, ang nais lang natin, i-present yung salita ng Diyos in the clearest and purest way nang sa gayon yung tao, tumanggap siya because nakita niya ang katotohanan ng salita ng Diyos na siya ay makasalanan at kailangan niya ang Diyos sa buhay niya. Hindi ang nangyari, nagkaroon ng manipulation by the words that we say, and because of that, yung tao tumanggap. So ang tendency, tinanggap niya si Lord sa puso, hindi niya tinanggap si Lord sa puso. Sabi nga, at the very beginning of salvation, it is the Holy Spirit who takes the initiative and brings conviction to the sinning heart. A description of what takes place when one is converted is provided by Paul in 2 Thessalonians 2:13 and by Peter in 1 Peter 1:2. Sabi doon, for this reason, we also thank God without ceasing, because when you receive the word of God, which you heard from us, you welcome it not as the word of men, but as it is in truth, the word of God, which also effectively works in you who believe. So belief of the truth leads to salvation through the choosing and setting apart of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit lays his hand upon the sinner's head, the sinner responds by receiving a love of truth based on 2 Thessalonians 2:10. And faith springs up in his heart. So again, it's the Holy Spirit working, not us. Tayo lang yung boses ng Banal na Espiritu. So this completed work within the heart of man is called the new birth. In John 3:5, Jesus answered, "Most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God." O ito yung tinatawag nating born again experience. Other terms for conversion in Galatians 4:6, Galatians 3:27, Romans 8:9, 1 Corinthians 12:13. So in all the descriptions and the use of different terms to explain the conversion of the believer, it is clearly stated that the Holy Spirit is the agent at conversion. Again, it is the Holy Spirit, not us. Kaya nga, no manipulation. As we see, ang gusto natin is the pure, clear word of God presenting in their lives or presented in their lives. Sabi natin dito, he convicts men of sin, sanctifies or sets them apart unto salvation, and they are born of the Spirit. He witnesses that they are the children of God. Pagkatapos na tumanggap, they who are Christ have the Spirit of Christ. The Holy Spirit baptizes them into the body of Christ, and the Holy Spirit resides in their hearts. Thus, we see that all true born-again believers have the Holy Spirit. So, kung ikaw ay mananampalataya ngayon, ang Banal na Espiritu ay nananahan na sa iyong buhay. Kaya ngayon din ay katibayan na tayo ay pinatawad ng Diyos sa ating mga kasalanan. Again, sabi natin dito, all that they have in the way of Christian vitality and experience is the work of the Holy Spirit. In John 20:27, sabi nga, John 20:22 pala, sorry. As the bread of the Almighty gave life to man and began the old world. So the breath of the mighty Savior gave life to his ministers and began the new world. Nung naresurrect na si Jesus, when he breathed on them, he breathed on them the Holy Spirit. And again, na uulit yung experience na yun as we receive Christ in our lives, asking for forgiveness for our sins. Now the Holy Spirit is with you and shall be in you. Kasama mo at nananahan sa iyo. In John 14 verse 17, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot conceive or cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him, but you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. In John 20:22, sabi nga, and when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. So John 20:22 was the first step of the Spirit's incoming. The fulfillment of John 14 verse 17 came on the day of Pentecost. So again, iba yung infilling of the Holy Spirit and dwelling of the Holy Spirit. Yung John 14 or John 20:22, sabi nga natin dito, ito yung dwelling of the Holy Spirit. Yung John 14 verse 17 na nagkaroon ng sa katuparan doon sa Pentecost is what we call the infilling of the Holy Spirit, o yung term na naririnig natin na puspos tayo ng banal na Espiritu. Now, in regeneration, there is the impartation of life by the Spirit's power, and the one who receives it is saved. In the infilling with the Holy Spirit, there is the impartation of power, and the one who receives it is fitted for service. So to have the Spirit is one thing, but to be filled with the Spirit is something else. The disciples, after Jesus has breathed on them the Holy Spirit in John 20:22, were commanded to wait in Jerusalem until they were filled in Luke 24:49. Today, it is not necessary to tarry in order to receive the Holy Spirit. Noon, sinabi sa kanilang Panginoon, kailangan nila maghintay, because again, wala pa yung day of Pentecost, because the Holy Spirit would be given sa day of Pentecost. Bakit sila pinapaintay ni Lord? Remember, nabuhay si Lord 40 days and 40 nights. Now, nung nabuhay si Lord hanggang sa Pentecost, that would be 50 days. Kaya sabi ni Lord, you need to wait. Kaya sabi natin dito, today, it is not necessary to tarry in order to receive the Holy Spirit or to wait. After the day of Pentecost, there is no record anywhere that anyone waited, cried, agonized, sung, struggled, or tarried to be filled with the Holy Spirit. So sa panahon natin ngayon, kung titignan natin, ang kailangan lang natin is to receive the Holy Spirit. Now, ang malaking tanong ng karamihan, Pastor, kung ako ba ay hindi puspos ng banal na Espiritu, ako ba ay ligtas at pupunta pa rin sa langit? Of course, pupunta pa rin tayo sa langit at tayo pa rin ay ligtas. Now, ano yung advantage that we are filled with the Holy Spirit? When we are filled with the Holy Spirit, we are being edified by the Holy Spirit as we pray in tongues, as we are filled with the Holy Spirit, ang nangyayari, mas lalong nakakilos ang Diyos in us, and people will see God's glory through us. So sa panahon natin ng ngayon, ang kailangan lang natin sabihin, ang kailangan lang natin gawin ay tanggapin ang banal na Espiritu, pasalamatan natin. Ibig sabihin ang sasabihin natin, Lord, salamat po, ako ay anak mo at ako ay puspos ng banal na Espiritu at ako po ay magsasalita ng ibang wika. And sabi, probably, ang isipin nyo, Pastor, hindi pa nga ako nagsasalita ng ibang wika. That's why we act in faith based on the Word of God. We receive it and then we thank God and then we just wait on the manifestation of God and the Holy Spirit in our lives. So steps to receiving the Holy Spirit. Number one, recognize that the gift has already been given based on Acts 19 verse 1 to 2, Acts 8 verse 14 to 15. Sabi nga natin dito, Paul never taught the people to pray that God would give them the Holy Spirit. He instructed them to simply receive what has already been given. Number two, salvation is the only condition. Tayo ba ay humingi ng tawad sa Panginoon? Tinanggap ba natin si Kristo sa ating mga buhay? At dahil doon, ang banal na Espiritu ay mananahan sa atin, indwelling at ang nais ng Holy Spirit ay mapuspos pa tayo ng banal na Espiritu in feeling. So paano yun? We would just receive that. Sabi nga natin dito in Acts 2, verse 38 to 39, then Peter said to them, repent and let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, for the promise is to you and to your children and to all who are afar off, as many as the Lord our God will call. So again, you don't have to be perfect. Anyone who is saved can receive the gift of the Holy Spirit now. Hindi bukas, hindi sa mangkalawa, now. Ang kailangan lang nating gawin, i-recognize, ibinigay na yan. So tanggapin lang natin, pasalamatan natin, at hintayin natin ang manifestation nito. Technically speaking, kung titignan natin, we are already filled with the Holy Spirit. Kasi sabi nga sa Bible, tayo ay magkakaroon ng pagbabago ng buhay. Ang pangalawang bagay na senyales na tayo ay puspos ng banal na Espiritu, yung tayo ay makakapagsalita sa ibang wika. Now, bakit nais natin makapagsalita sa ibang wika? Para tayo mismo mapatunayan natin, tayo nga ay puspos ng banal na Espiritu. Kasi ang nangyari, hindi natin masigurado sa sarili natin kung puspos pa tayo ng banal na Espiritu, kasi nga hindi tayo nagsasalita sa ibang wika. Pero kung titingnan natin, ang isang preba na tayo ay puspos ng banal na Espiritu dahil tayo ay lumalakad sa pagbabago na ginawa ng Diyos. So, ang purpose ng speaking in tongues is for you to be sure without a shadow of a doubt na ikaw nga ay puspos ng banal na Espiritu. Hindi yan para sa ibang tao, kundi para sa iyo. Makumbinsi ka mismo na ikaw ay puspos ng banal na Espiritu. Number 3 is through the laying on of hands based on Acts 19 verse 6, Acts 8 verse 17. So laying on of hands is a point of contact that although not essential to receiving, will help the person place themselves in a position to easily receive. So pwede kang i-lay hands, pwede din namang hindi. Meaning pwede may mag-pray sa'yo, pwede namang ikaw na i-claim mo lang yon, pasalamatan mo yon sa pangalan ni Jesus. Number 4, expect to speak with tongues. Now, meron mga nagtuturo na probably makukuha mo is speaking in tongues ng demonyo. Now, again, kung titingnan natin, kung ang tinatawag natin si Jesus, ang worship natin si Jesus, so I don't believe na magkakaroon ng manifestation ng evil spirit doon, kasi ando doon ang presensya ng Diyos, mas makapangyarihan ng Diyos kesa sa evil spirit. So malabo tayong masingitan doon, you know, as we see. Sabi nga natin dito, expect to speak with tongues. Kung titingnan natin, doon sa Acts 2 verse 1 to 4, they spoke with tongues. Acts 8 verse 14 to 18, Acts 10 verse 44 to 46, Acts 19 verse 1 to 6, and 1 Corinthians 14 verse 2 and verse 4. Now, the child of God need not fear receiving something else. Yun nga yung sinabi natin kanina, imposible tayo masingitan because we are worshiping God, glorifying God, and asking the Holy Spirit's power in us. Dun sa Luke 11 verse 11 to 13, sabi nga dito, if a son asks for bread from any father among you, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will he give him a serpent instead or of a fish? Or if he asks for an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask of Him? So we can be assured that God will not give His children a counterfeit when they ask Him for the Holy Spirit. Number 6, receive the Holy Spirit and speak the language He gives. So the Holy Spirit, Siya yung magbibigay sa atin ng mga bagay na sasabihin natin when it comes to speaking in tongues. Although mayroong dalawang klase ng tongues, personally I call yung Acts 2 experience is the known tongue. The known tongue kasi nga mayroong nakakaunawa pero hindi natin yun wika pag sinabi natin. Yun namang 1 Corinthians 14 is unknown tongue kasi walang nakakaunawa at kailangan ng interpretation. Number 7, i-discuss natin yan as we go along the way. Number seven, sabi nga natin dito, or sorry, number six, the candidate should be instructed not to speak even one word in their natural language. You cannot speak two languages at the same time. Ang kailangan niya lang is what yield to the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit would speak through him. Hindi natin pwedeng turuan yung candidate na ito yung sabihin mo, hindi pwedeng ganun. Ulit-ulitin lang, tapos bibilisan, hindi pwedeng ganun. It's the Holy Spirit that would give them utterance. Number seven, not confusing crowds should gather around the candidates. Sabi nga natin dito, sometimes when going swimming, it is hard to get some people to go into the water. But if you go in and swim around, telling them how good it is, they will come on in also. Kasi nga, yung iba ang nagsasabi, hindi yan para sa atin. Kaya nila sinasabi yun, kasi nga hindi naman nila na-experience yung infilling of the Holy Spirit. Kaya ang sinasabi nila, para sa iba lang yan, hindi yan para sa lahat. So, ang mas maganda sigurong tanungin ay yung tao na na-experience yung infilling of the Holy Spirit, kung ito ba talaga ay magandang experience na maranasan din natin. But we would like to clarify, hindi man tayo mag-speak in tongues, pupunta pa rin tayo sa langit. Hindi man tayo nag-speak in tongues, born again pa rin tayo. Hindi man tayo nag-speak in tongues, pwede pa rin tayo gamitin ni Lord mightily sa kanyang ubasan. We would just like to clarify that. Now, why should the believers speak in tongues? Sabi nga, it is one of the initial signs of the infilling of the Holy Spirit. So, it is not just a design, but one of the initial sign of the infilling of the Holy Spirit, based on Acts 2 verse 4, Acts 10 verse 46, and Acts 19 verse 6. So, tongues are used for spiritual edification and refreshment in 1 Corinthians 14 verse 4. Tongues reminds us of the Spirit indwelling presence in John 14 verse 16 to 17. It will keep our prayers in line with God's will in Romans 8 verse 26 and 1 Corinthians 14:14. Speaking in tongues keeps selfishness out of our prayers and allows us to pray exactly what we need to pray, what needs to be prayed and how we pray. Praying in tongues stimulates faith, based on Jude 1 verse 20. Because the Holy Spirit supernaturally directs the word I speak, faith must be exercised to speak in tongues. I don't know what the next word will be. I trust God for that. Trusting God in this area of my life helps me trust in all areas or other areas in my life. Now, tongues will keep us free from worldly contamination, based on 1 Corinthians 14, verse 28. Sabi nga, we can speak with tongues to ourselves on the job, at the market, on the bus, anywhere. This is a means of keeping ourselves free from contamination. But of course, be sensitive, kasi mamaya, nagsasalita ka ron at nakita ka naman katabi mo, baka akalain na nasisiraan ka na ng ulo, sasalita ka, wala ka namang kausap. Ibig sabihin, pwede naman tayong mag-speak in tongues o manalangin na hindi naman natin binubuka yung bibig natin sa isip natin, you know? Praying in tongues praying in tongues enables us to pray for the unknown. Kasi di ba, may mga pagkakataon na kung saan pinapaalala sa atin ng Diyos ang isang tao, ang isang pangyayari, pero hindi natin alam kung ano yung dapat ipanalangin. So ito yung pagkakataon na tayo ay manalangin, at ang banal na spirito na ang magtuturo nito sa atin. Praying in tongues gives thanks well, based on 1 Corinthians 14 verse 15 to 17. Sabi nga natin dito, praying in tongues provides the most perfect way to pray and give thanks. But in the presence of people who are unlearned in spiritual things, you should pray with your understanding also, so they can be edified, so they will understand what you say. Kaya nga sabi ni Paul sa 1 Corinthians, if we pray in tongues at church, mas maganda may interpretation. Ngayon, kung wala siyang interpretation, mas maigi na lang hinaan mo siya or sarilinin mo siya, kasi nga ikaw lang naman yung na-edify at hindi ito naunawaan ng iba. Now, speaking in tongues brings the tongue under subjection. Kasi sabi nga ni James, sa James 3 verse 8, ang dila ang pinaka mahirap i-tame. So, para ma-tame yung dila natin na hindi lalabas dyan ang sumpa at pagpupuri, kundi pagpupuri lang lumabas, we speak in tongues. So yielding your tongue to the Holy Spirit to speak with another tongue is a giant step toward fully yielding all of our members to God. Because if you can yield this most unruly member, you can yield any member. So praise the Lord, at ang dalangin natin at naunawaan natin, ang Holy Spirit ay hindi kapangyarihan ng Diyos, kundi ang Holy Spirit ay mismong isang karakteristik ng Diyos. Ang Holy Spirit ay ang Diyos mismo, at ang Banal na Espiritu ay nananahan sa atin, kasama natin. Kaya nga mas maganda, mas maunawaan natin ang Banal na Espiritu, dahil ang Banal na Espiritu ay ang Diyos mismo. Sige po, tayo manalangin. Salamat Panginoon sa mga bagay na amin pong natutunan sa iyong mga salita, na tunay nga ang Holy Spirit, ikaw Holy Spirit ay Diyos na sumasama sa amin, kasama namin at nanahan sa amin, at dalangin namin patuloy pa naming maranasan, makita ayon sa salita ng Diyos kung sino ka sa buhay namin. Salamat po Ama, ito po ay aming dalangin sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen. Godspeed. Hello guys, meron po tayong good news. Meron na tayong online Champions for Christ Bible Training Program. Now, ang tanong nyo, sino ba ang pwede mag-aral dyan, Pastor? Kung Pastor ka, pwede ka mag-aral. Kung member ka, pwede ka mag-aral. Saka sa mga leaders sa church, pwede ka mag-aral. Kahit nga hindi ka born again, pwede ka mag-aral. Yung apat na yan, pwede mag-aral. Idagdag mo pa yung pure youth sa Bible. So, yung mga lima na yan ang pwede mag-aral. Now, ang gagawin natin sa online Bible course natin, meron tayong set up na class, meaning pwede ka sumama sa isang class and may schedule yun. So, dun kayo mag-online para mag-start ng Bible school natin. Meron ding also customized and catered for your personal need. Kasi ang katwiran ng bank, Pastor, di ko pwede ng tatlong beses sa isang linggo pumasok. Hindi ako pwedeng pumasok ng gintong araw. Ang available ko lang is dalawang araw. Kaya hindi ako pwede sa gabi. Hindi ako pwede sa umaga. So, ito na yung mag-eliminate sa mga reasons natin para ika nga matugunan. And I do believe God gave us the wisdom para talaga ma-address yung desire natin na makapag-aral. Yung nga lang, there are acceptable reasons kung bakit hindi tayo makapag-enroll. So, yung customize, i-PM mo lang ako or i-email mo ako kung gusto mong mag-enroll para i-customize natin yung schedule para sa'yo. And I do believe ang kalooban ng Diyos talaga ma-equip tayo, or sa atin na hindi pa natututunan ng Biblia, pag-aralan natin ng Biblia para mas lalo nating maintindihan at maunawaan ang plano ng Diyos at kalooban ng Diyos sa ating mga buhay. So guys, ano pang iniintay nyo? Mag-PM lang kayo or mag-email sa akin para malaman ko kung interesado kayo. And I believe, mag-aaral kayo sa Bible School na to, your life will never be the same again. Godspeed!